Time for a fatal four-way! Dun, dun, dun. Oh, there's some talented wrestlers coming for us.
So, you're saying that even when I click to empty the recycle bin, your stuff is still there?
100%.
I've been waiting here for an hour, Stone Cold. Heyman said 1 o'clock.
I swear, I didn't contact him.
I called Luke. Thanks for coming, man.
Let's do this thing.
Oh, right, I got limited time. Where's the disruptor?
Okay, this one is my fault.
What are you doing here, peons?
I ain't no peon.
That's the rock for ya. Dishing everybody.
Watch your mouth, rock.
Ooh, game on. It's everybody against everyone.
Hey, shut up! This ain't no cable news channel. We settle our beefs in the ring. Let's get it!
Let's get it. That's a weird thing to say. Let's get it on, maybe? Let's get in the ring.
Let's get it.
What?
Dun, 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 dun. Alright. Jesus, 95? Why does The Rock look like Bruce Willis? His face looks like Bruce Willis. I don't know. First, a couple of entrances.
Then we get to fight.
Yay, fight.
I'm ready, game. The game is failing, by the way. Keep getting more critical errors. Sometimes a pop-up just shows up mid-game and it's like, error, all rewards will not be stored or something. It's like, what the fuck, 2K? Spend time on the first 5 levels of the game and then you were like, fuck it, let's release it?
Boo!
God, I hope somebody else gets the license for wrestling games. 2K is fucked up so many times now, it's bleh. I miss the old wrestling games. THQ stuff was better, I think. I know, the last couple of wrestling games were crap. I remember when C16 came out, you had the showcase mode of Stone Cold, that was pretty awesome. But the game was already glitchy. And all the DLC that you got more expensive, but you get less value for your money, because with 2K15 you got new showcases. So you actually had to, you know, do matches, follow a new storyline and unlock characters. With 2K16 they were just like, oh, for all that money, here are a few new skins and 5 more wrestlers, yay. Like, what the fuck is that? But then, okay, I was like, okay, maybe 16 is like a transitional title. They will put some more effort into 17. And 17 didn't even have a showcase. It had a horrible career mode where you had mic skills, but there was no audio in it. So you just saw your character's mouth move like a goldfish, like rip, 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 and then dialogue popped up on the screen. Well, what the hell was that? That's so stupid. 18 didn't even have a showcase, and I skipped that one entirely. 17 I returned. I bought it, I pre-ordered it. It was like, I'll give it a chance. Played it for like half an hour, I'm like, fuck this shit, and I returned it. 18 I skipped because, you know, showcase mode, nothing to do. Then 19 came and Daniel Bryan, showcase mode is back, nice. That's so many bugs and glitches.
Here we go.
But then 20 came along and it was like, Jesus Christ. The game doesn't even run. What the hell did it do? It looked horrible. It still looks horrible. It looks like an early Xbox 360 game. So many glitches and bugs. Pretty shitty campaign / showcase mode. But it's such a shame because there's like a DLC pack of Asuka, which is, I think, also a showcase mode. It's like, that sounds interesting, but the game is so crap. You'll pick it up when it's like $5 or something, but I'd rather have that they just skip a year. No, make a wrestling game, then bring out DLC packs even in the year that's after the game, and then skip a year and then, you know, make a good game again. Like, for instance, you would make a game in 2020, and then you would release DLC in 2020 and 2021, and in 2022 you would just release a new game, or even maybe in 2023, with actual new stuff. Not just like FIFA or NBA or NFL treatment, no, actually new stuff. Which will give you proper time to, you know, work on it. And then also, if you then release DLC packs, you can spread it out over 2 years. Make better DLC packs, not just, here are 5 new wrestlers for $50 or something stupid like that. No, just give a showcase mode, or give a new option like a manager mode or something like that. Something that keeps people interested. Then you can easily play a game for 2 years, or longer. And when a new one comes out, everybody's like, oh fuck yeah, there's really something new to see. No, just reskins of older games. And with 2020 they did something horrible. They tried to make something new and they made it PS2 quality. It's like, ah, guys, come on. Dare has money for that. Luckily, you know, people voted with the wallet and everybody was like, fuck this shit. Now there isn't one coming. I mean, now we are in October now, so normally 2K21 would have come out, but they're skipping because the previous one was so shit, they're like, we need to figure something new out. I'm like, yeah, I'm happy. We should vote with our wallets more often. I mean, this game is pretty crap too, but at least it's not full price. You know, you could argue that, you know, you pay half the money, you get half a game. Yeah. But even this is a lot of microtransactions and stuff, options and money and same moveset. I keep telling you, man, they tried to make this for a mobile phone and they were like, oh, well, we can release it on a console too. Whatever. It's not the best. It's not the worst, but it's not the best. We won. Sorry, Rock. Rock was about to pin, but oh well. Gabriel Pierce, Luke Gallows, R-Truth and The Rock. We won. Can you smell the victory? Yeah, me just ranting about how shit 2K is. Oh well. Feels that way, especially since the game keeps crashing now, giving critical errors or giving errors mid-game. It's just... I got a say, Aunt Judy. Your nephew surprised us all today. Gabriel's been surprising us since the day he was born. Can you call me the Disruptor? The what? Have you lost your mind? It's my WWE name.
I still can't believe you beat us.
I can believe the deliciousness of the sweet potato pie. Little Jimmy, wanna taste it? Little Jimmy reference, you have to know R-Truth from back in the day. Losing always stings, but does sting quite as much as getting beat by a kid like this in his own hometown battleground. I'm stuffed. Thanks for having us over before we hit the road, Aunt Judy.
Of course, Truth. Come back anytime. Look out for my Gabriel now!
It's the Disruptor.
Look out for my Disruptor now!